Right, friends, welcome back to third capsule of 31st week. This is a commercial dispute between Antrix and Devas. This Antrix is the commercial arm of ISRO. ISRO is the Indian Space Research Organization, and it is with the Department of Space. And ISRO chairman at present is AS Kiran Kumar, and he is also the chairman of a Space Commission, and at the same time, ISRO chairman is the secretary to Department of Space. These things don't forget. So ISRO is under Department of Space, and Antrix looks at the commercial aspects of ISRO, and the other side is Devas Multimedia Limited. Most of the investors are from Mauritius, and there is a commercial dispute between Antrix and Devas Multimedia Private Limited. And before going into the commercial dispute, let us look at the bilateral investment treaty. This bilateral investment treaties are the treaties between two sovereign countries. India has got bilateral investment treaties with several countries, and similarly, India has one bilateral investment treaty with Mauritius. And you may ask, what exactly happens when bilateral investment treaty is there? Bilateral investment treaty basically protects the investments made by the nationals of one country in another country. If the nationals of one country make investments in other sovereign countries, this bilateral investment treaty looks at protecting those investments. That means the investments made by foreign countries should also get fair and equitable treatment, just like domestic investments. Second one is, they should be protected from expropriation. You may ask, what is meant by expropriation? Expropriation is the taking over of the private property by the governments. That is expropriation. And free transfer of means should be there for the foreign investments. Then full protection and security should be there for foreign investments. So when bilateral investment treaty is there between one country and other country, then the foreign investments are to be given fair and equitable treatment, just like domestic investments. And if the investor feels that these are violated, then what is the option left for the company which feels aggrieved? They can go for international arbitration. When bilateral investment treaty is there, they can go for international arbitration by involving the clause of investor-state dispute settlement mechanism, or popularly known as ISDS mechanism. So by invoking ISDS mechanism, when bilateral investment treaty exists between two countries, the company aggrieved can go for international arbitration. And sometimes they can go for arbitration under the auspices of ICSID. ICSID, you may ask, what is ICSID? ICSID is the arm of World Bank Group, that is International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes. This arm of World Bank is specifically established to look at investment disputes. So in this case, what happened is, the investor has gone, that means Devas Multimedia Private Limited, which felt aggrieved because of the state action, has gone for arbitration through two channels. One channel is International Chamber of Commerce. You may ask, what is International Chamber of Commerce? International Chamber of Commerce is the business organization where thousands of companies across the world are members. It is based in Paris. And Devas Multimedia invoked arbitration clause with the International Chamber of Commerce Tribunal based in Paris. Not only that, it also invoked arbitration clause with Permanent Court of Arbitration. You may ask what is meant by permanent court of arbitration. Permanent court of arbitration is not a court. It is a dispute settlement mechanism. It is based in The Hague, Netherlands, and it is intergovernmental body. So, one side it is International Chamber of Commerce, a Paris-based body. Other side, permanent court of arbitration based in The Hague, Netherlands. Through these two channels, the company Devas Multimedia Limited has gone for arbitration. So, before going into the arbitration award, let us look at the dispute. First and the foremost is Antrix awarded contract to Devas Multimedia Private Limited in 2005. Under this agreement, Devas acquired 12-year lease of two ISRO satellites to be operated in S-band spectrum. You may ask what is meant by S-band spectrum. S-band spectrum is basically 2500 megahertz spectrum or 2.5 gigahertz spectrum, which is basically used for high-speed internet. It is basically meant for 4G services, which operate on long-term evolution technique or LTE technology. So, for high-speed internet communication through LTE technology, this S-band spectrum is useful, and this is 2.5 gigahertz or 2500 megahertz spectrum, and this was taken on lease for 12 years by Devas Multimedia from ISRO through two satellites. So, this is the issue. Later on, what happened? In the year 2011, the famous newspaper group of India, The Hindu, and its business newspaper Business Line carried an investigative report, and it brought out irregularities in the deal. And subsequently, Controller and Auditor General of India, the Audit Institution of India, in its draft audit report in 2011, pointed out serious financial irregularities and favoritism. And subsequently, the central government decided to scrap the deal by stating that the country needed this S-band spectrum in the larger national and strategic purpose. Right? The arbitration tribunal felt that it is expropriation, that is taking over private property by the governments. And the Devas Multimedia Limited, having felt aggrieved, approached International Chamber of Commerce Tribunal in Paris, and in September 2015, it imposed a fine of $672 million. And now the Permanent Court of Arbitration in The Hague felt that India is liable for expropriating the investments made by some Mauritius investors of Devas Multimedia. So, the Permanent Court of Arbitration felt that the government has taken over privately owned property. That is the meaning of expropriation, and it imposed approximately $1 billion as a compensation. Right? So, this is the present state, and we have to wait and see how the government of India will react. And meanwhile, CBI filed charge sheet, and it filed charge sheet against former ISRO chairman Madhavan Nair, in addition to several other employees. And let us wait and watch how the government of India will respond in future to the awards of ICC Tribunal at Paris as well as Permanent Court of Arbitration at The Hague, Netherlands. Right, friends, with this let us conclude the third capsule. Please do join for other capsules. Have a nice day. Thank you.